Heyo, it's me Harper Savage, and today I'm going to be working on some Inktober prompts. I cannot guarantee that I'm going to be doing voiceovers for every single prompt that I do. I just figured I would start off the first video with some kind of voice. So I just have this square sketchbook here that I'm going to be using. It has like super thick paper, why I chose it. It's so nice, look at how thick it is. But anyways, the first prompt I'm going to be doing is Crescent. I'm going to be following a prompt list that I picked out on Instagram. It's not the official prompt list for Inktober because the official prompt list had too many words that I didn't know what to do with. So I chose something that was a bit more easy for me. I'll be sure to link it down in the comments below in case you're interested in what prompt list I'm following. But the word is Crescent, like moon crescent. So I figured I'd start off kind of easy, do something simple for the first word. I'm going to be drawing, obviously, a moon. I don't know how big I want to make it, though. I have a little thumbnail sketch to my side here that I'm going to be referencing. Maybe a bit bigger. Okay, now that I kind of have the size I want, we can take my little compass here and make better circular shape. Is that where I want it? Maybe shift it over a little bit more. I'm trying to make it even on both sides here. Using the best ways of measuring by using my fingers instead of using a ruler. Oh no, I lost the spot. All right, let's try this again. Yeah, it's about where I had it. I think it's a little bit high up on the page now, though. Yeah, it's a little shifted off. Alright, I have an idea. We're gonna use a ruler, even though it's against my better judgment. Oh no, this eraser sucks. Sometimes you just need to clean it. Now, I'm not trying to draw super dark here. It just keeps happening. I don't know. Alright, so I made it a little bit smaller. And I centered it the best way I could. Now I'm gonna kind of mark out, or I'm gonna take away parts of it because it is a crescent. Nice and crisp. All right, so I've seen this like before, I think, because I'm not sure where I got this idea from, but I think I've seen it before where like they drew the or had Photoshopped, I don't know. I don't even know what it was. But the trees are like in the moon. Like it's a landscape within the moon. I thought that was pretty cool. So I kind of wanted to do that. Like pine trees, the pointy trees. What if I did a crystal moon? Maybe not all the way up. Or what if I did just do the whole thing? I don't know if I want to do an entire moon of crystal. I don't know if I'd liked it as partial. Well, I don't hate it. Okay, well, this crystal idea kind of ruined my plan of having like these cool like leafy bits around it. Like I was gonna do something cute and whimsical, like the stuff that you would see in a bullet journal or something, where it would be like the little leafies. I mean, I guess I could still kind of do that. Just, I don't know, I don't think it's gonna look as cool with them now. I think I'm not going to have them. So much for the compass and ruler. Oh, hello, Sark Chibi. Can I help you? Okay, so I'm going to be using this glass dip pen. It has a rainbow in it. And I'm going to be using some black ink. I can't tell you what the ink is because I think it's actually like a bunch of different like little tiny bottles that were mixed together when I got the dip pens, because I got a bunch of dip pens and they all come with their own little ink vial, so I just kind of put them all together into one jar to make it easier. Oh god, can I get it open? Yes. All right, it's open. Remember that it's open. But first I'm gonna washi tape the edges. That part is done terribly. Try that again. Oh man, it still looks crooked. What the heck is going on here? Who knew this would be so hard? Well, I wish I hadn't wasted so much washi tape on the edges here, but whatever. My plan is to go through and do all the lines that I have here with the dip pen. And then I want to paint in the background. And then I want to tweak it and put more detail into it with the pen after I do the background. So I'm just going to keep this kind of close to me here so I don't drip too much. Now that I have that done, I'm gonna go ahead and get out that paintbrush. I'm just using a cheap one. You might recognize it from my other video. It has that cool glitter inside, some kind of liquid effect to it. I'm just gonna use the ink that I was using. I know this brush seems ridiculously small, but I actually picked it out to go around the edges of the moon easy. I probably should use an angled brush for that. All right, I pulled out this angled brush. It has gold glitter in it and like one random pink one. Oh, interesting. This one's never been used before, as you can tell. I'm going to ruin it now. I'm gonna wait for this first layer to dry and then I'm gonna go back over it again. Don't forget to do all the cool YouTube-y things and of comment, liking, and subscribing, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye!